National Walking Day.
Yes, that's a good idea.
So hopefully it will be dry.
It will be. It'll be a little bit breezier, and hopefully all that slush that some folks got last night, including here, will melt, and I think it will.
Good.
That's good news, isn't
it? Get it out of here.
Yeah, indeed. Now, we do have some one area that is still under a flood warning. That would be that Yellow Breaches Creek at about 7.7. That is where it stands currently. That is falling right now. That's the good news. So it is above flood stage, but it will continue to fall here throughout the morning. And I would say by lunchtime, hopefully this thing is back in its banks. But boy, what a weekend. Heavy rain, many areas getting about 3 inches or more rainfall. And then you mix a couple of inches of snow and sleet on top of that. And what a weekend it was, folks. March not letting up, and neither winter to the bitter end. Just had one more act for us here. River levels today, Sunbury above 14 feet, Harrisburg trending towards 7 feet, the Marietta branch at 41.2, Juniata River at 7.1. The rivers will crest later today or tomorrow. Later today for the Juniata at 9 feet, 18.2 tomorrow for Sunbury, 12 feet along the Susquehanna and Harrisburg tomorrow, and 45.8 for Marietta. So we don't expect any river flooding out of this, but certainly those smaller streams and creeks rose to near their banks, and the Yellow Breaches went over. At Camp Hill had 4.5 inches of rain, so no surprise the Yellow Breaches took off. Hanover at 4.44, Red Line coming in at over 2.5 inches of rain, and Mannheim and Chambersburg as well, some significant amounts, but it was the snow and slush that formed in that thin band, that deformation band, that created a mess last night. Gratz had 4 inches of snow, Elizabethville at 3. Mangus Mills, 2.5 inches. Abbottstown at 2.1, and Fort Hunter coming in at 1.8. That has since left us behind, but still across Pennsylvania, you can see the extreme southern tier getting still a little bit of wet snow and slush. Most of us are clear, but boy, it took a while for this thing to leave, and now that is all pushed east. So the areas we looked at last half hour, Redding and down into Honeybrook there and East Earl, all of that has since pushed us to the east and continues to do so now for New Jersey. But wow, what a mess, folks. What a mess as we continue here to see things wrap up. 20s over the mountains of the western part of the state, 23 degrees in Bradford. Harrisburg is at 40 degrees. Many of us in the 30s and low 40s. That is helping to keep anything from refreezing here, which is good news. Millersville University just looks wet. Plenty of moisture in the atmosphere, but look at the winds gusting well over 30 miles an hour. It will continue to be breezy today with temperatures here starting out in the mid to upper 30s. This was an upper level system that created that snow yesterday that formed that thin band. That band now pushing eastward. There goes the main event that was on Saturday, but it didn't really matter because the rain continued into Sunday thanks to that upper level system, and now high pressure getting ready to build in. The sun rising over Harrisburg here this morning. 56 degrees is now our average high. We'll continue to try to trend toward that today. And yesterday we had a record precipitation, over 2 inches of rain. Don't forget Tuesday night, tomorrow night, Beyond the Forecast returns. We've got some spring topics for you. So we will force spring to get here no matter what. And we're excited for that program. We hope you'll join us tomorrow night at 7:30. In the meantime, as I said, there goes that low. Breezy conditions here today, and high pressure building in today and tomorrow look dry with some more rain arriving here really for several days by the end of the week. A nice spring-like high temperature map for you. Des Moines, Iowa is going to be at 71 degrees today. We will be in the mid-50s, but we'll take what we can get at this point, folks, as long as the snow is out of here and done with, and there it goes. So mostly sunny here today, breezy. Tomorrow looks good as well. After a clear night, it will be a chilly night again. Temperatures dropping into the lower to mid-30s, and then as we move into the day tomorrow, maybe a few clouds from time to time, but so we look into Wednesday again, more showery activity moving our direction. So don't be surprised if we see perhaps another inch of rain from Wednesday through Friday with more showery activity. But we're into April here by that point, James. So those April showers hopefully helping the Mayflowers and temperatures staying mild here through this week. But what a weekend.
Just terrible.
Yeah, awful, awful stuff. And we hope the Yellow Breaches goes back in its banks here soon.
Good.
Yeah.
At least you said the key word this week, mild.
Indeed.
We'll take what we can get.
Yes, sir.